Hello, on this video I'm going to show you how to use the POST methods to pass information from one page to another page. And I'm going to be using Visual Studio 2015 and ASP.NET Web Forms. The first thing is to create a project. Click OK. I'm going to create an empty ASP.NET. Click OK. Right click right here on your project and add a new item. I'm going to add a web form. I'm going to call it index. I'm going to right click on index and set as a start page. Inside the form, I'm going to put a couple of text box, and ID is going to be first name, run at server, very, very important. I'm going to create a second text box, but this time I'm going to call it last name. And now I need a button to submit this. A ASP button. ID equals button. Run at server as well. Text submit. And post back URL is what we're going to create. We don't have that yet. So let's create a second page where this form is gonna go. Right click on the project and add a web form. I'm gonna name it second page. So now I can set it to second page. So all this is one text box, a second text box, and then a submit button. And when I click on this button, I want this information here to be available on my second page. Let's take a look on the design. So what I have is one box, another box, and a submit button. Back to source. Now we are ready to change our second page. I'm going to my second page, and right here on the ASP.cs file, whenever the page loads, I want to get the information that one page is posting to the second page. So string first name equals request.form, and also the last name, the request.form. Now let's take a look on the ID of what the first page is posting to the second page. So the first page is posting these two information right here. One is text box first name, the other one is text box last name. So I'm going to copy this ID and I'm gonna paste it right here. And the other one, if you remember, was last name. So now I have the information from the first page available on my second page. And right here on my second page, I'm going to create a couple of labels. LBL first name, run at server, very important. And the second one, LBL last name. So on my second page, I have two labels, and I'm going to display the information right here on these labels. So now that I have the label, on the second page, I know I have a label called LBL first name dot text, and the text, I want to be the first name. And the LBL last name dot text, I want it to be the last name. So let's review this. The first page is my index page. I have two text boxes, and when I click on submit, it posts these two information to my second page. Once it gets to the second page, on page load, remember, page load is a function that runs whenever the page loads. So whenever the second page is loading, I want to get this information from the first page, and then I just want to put it on a couple of labels that I created. So let's run this program. So the first name, I'm going to put Joe Doe. Submit. And then if you look here in the URL, the second page now has the information from the first page. So very simple. That's how you pass information from one page to another page using the post method. This is very easy, and you can do it.